Welcome back. So you saved Highpool at the expense of Ag Center. A tough decision, and I know it must weigh heavily on your minds. But a choice had to be made, and once you chose Highpool, you did all you could to save it and its people. I'm particularly pleased that you helped Kate Preston become the new mayor over there. She's the kind of pragmatic, level-headed leader the old place needs. Also, let me personally thank you for finding Ace's killer, whatever it was. I'm sorry your initiation into the Rangers has been such a trial by fire, but you've proven yourself tough under pressure, and in my eyes, that makes you fit to be a Ranger. Welcome aboard. Now, any questions? You are our next generation recruits, and I want you to make us proud. Remember that every action you take reflects directly upon the Desert Rangers as a whole. We've worked hard to gain the trust of the people of Arizona and to have them accept our authority. Keep that in mind every time you draw your weapon or make a promise. The lives of other Rangers and the rule of law depend on your wisdom, honor, and forbearance. Ace and I went way back to the prison days. We fought Finster and the base Cochise robot army together. We rebuilt the Citadel from scratch. That I sent him on the mission which got him killed hangs heavy on my heart, and Angie's never gonna forgive me. I don't know. Ace fought plenty of robots in his time, and they never gave him any trouble. So I'm wondering if this was something new, something worse. And if it is, we better find out. Listen, if you brought that thing back with you, or even just a part of it, show it to Mer Captain over in the armory, like I said. She might be able to ID it. And here, take this with you when you bring something to Mer Captain. It's a requisition form for some of Mer Captain's top shelf gear. For finding Ace's killer, you deserve it. It is your home now, recruits. A place to rest and resupply between missions. A place to learn and to share your knowledge with others. But it's more than that. Despite its tarnished history, the Citadel is a force for good, a shining beacon of justice in a dark land, a bulwark against barbarism in a world of lawlessness and brutality. Indeed, it is the furrowed field out of which the seeds of order will grow into a new and better civilization. Hey, forgive me. Get carried away sometimes, but I do believe we are making a difference despite my shortcomings, and that our flame must not be allowed to be snuffed out. That's why we need young, motivated recruits like yourselves. I've been too cautious, recruits. Since we took this place over 15 years ago, I focused too much on keeping the peace in areas we know, and not enough on outside threats. I wanted to rebuild, get our numbers up, but all I've really been doing is letting the world pass us by. Well, that's gotta change, and the change starts with you. You are going to find out where this threat is coming from. We have a library here, where we compile maps and information about the region to help us with our work. If you want to know about any old tech or ancient knowledge, go talk to old Flintlock there. If you've got map questions, see Gilbert. He's our cartographer. Flintlock was old when I was your age. Now he's ancient. Knows more about the history of the Desert Rangers than any man alive. And he'll tell you so himself. Gilbert was another one of my squad. We called him Frasher back in the day. A good man to have in a tight spot. Past his fighting days now, though. Took a wound during the Battle of Base Cochise and never fully recovered. Now, he's our cartographer, and damn good at it. You'll find him in the museum with Flintlock. Nelson's all right. A bit young, a bit rowdy, a bit gung-ho. But the Rangers need that now. We need new blood, like yourselves. Woodson's that man right over there, my radio wingman. The man who keeps me on the air. If you want to know more about the repeater units or how to use your radio, see him. One of the brightest minds in the Citadel. She's really helped us get our weapons and armor up to scratch, and she's always coming up with new and better stuff. Worth a visit just to see what she's got cooking. Our old stomping grounds, since right after the apocalypse. We moved out of there about 15 years ago when we took over this place. It wasn't a bad place, but the Citadel is more defensible. The Red Scorpions have moved into the prison since then. Nasty bunch from all accounts. They call themselves the Red Scorpion Militia now, and lately they've been filling the airwaves with a lot of trash about how they're the real law and order around here. Just another raider gang, if you ask me. I don't give them the time of day. Craziest jackalope we ever faced. Might have been human once. Might have been sane, too. But when we met him, he was a crazy android bent on wiping out the human race and replacing us all with mutants. Got his head in our museum, if you want to take a look. Place was nearly the death of us. Hell, it was nearly the death of the whole human race. Damned malevolent mainframe churning out an endless army of robots. If we hadn't stopped it, well, I hate to think. Well enough not to talk behind her back when she's standing right in front of her.
Better now, General.
Ain't no shame in grieving, Angie. You'll want to talk to our quartermaster, Sergeant Melson, about that. He'll provide you with all the weapons, armor, and gear you need to carry out your duties in the Wastelands. You may also want to talk to Ethel Mercaptan, or TNT 10, if you need something special. Our munitions expert. Crazy bastard is going to blow us all up one day. Does good work, though. In the field, his ordnance is highly reliable. It's just his workshop that scares the bejesus out of me. Make us proud, recruits.